Lights, camera, action!
Trying to do something different here. This actually might work out, so a little excited about this. Rearranged the living room just a little bit. Nothing like too crazy, too insane. But I just moved my desk away from the window that faces the front of the building. And so it's kind of odd, at least to me, like not having the apartment the way that it's been these past few months, but this might work. So we're gonna try this for a while. The outlet situation was precarious. Trying to figure out how to plug things in. Do I have enough like outlets for all these plugs, moving everything in a different spot? But I think we're good. All right, so it is 2024. I was hoping to have this video like done and published a few days ago, but whatever, life happens, right? And I also hope that this is in focus. I'm using a manual lens, so I want it to look nice, but you know, this is, yeah. Anyway, we are in 2024. I don't know, feeling optimistic and then also just looking at the state of things and just wondering, you know, what horrors await us this year. But you know, I hope you guys had a great holiday season. Hope you had a great Christmas, great New Year. Christmas was not the best for me. I just wasn't, you know, feeling too good. But when we got closer to New Year, I started, you know, just feeling a little better. Even like, you know, got like some champagne and, you know, I stayed here at the house, just, you know, drank champagne and watched Harry, When Harry Met Sally, had some caviar and blinis, you know, bringing the new year right. You know, I think initially with this video, I don't know what I was going to talk about. I was just going to be like, hey, welcome to 2024, you know, let's go, let's do it right. But then I saw the Cat Williams interview. And if you guys haven't seen it, check it out. You can look it up if you don't know what I'm talking about. But comedian Cat Williams was interviewed by Shannon Sharp on Shannon's podcast, Club Shay Shay. And just pretty much in the interview, just Cat just let the chopper spray. He went at so many comedians who he felt, you know, had been coming at him. He also just kind of like went at the industry at large. It's a pretty eye-opening interview. It's almost 3 hours long, but it's a pretty eye-opening interview. And, you know, Kat says some very outlandish things, and not all of them are true. I'm gonna say that. Some of them are obviously false. Like, I still chuckle at the thought of Cat Williams, like, a six-year-old, maybe, Cat Williams, reading 3,000 books in a year. Fam, that is just impossible. But what I came to realize is that, yeah, he sprinkled some, you know, just like obvious, incredulous lies throughout the interview, but that's because the stuff that he said that was true would just hit that much harder once, like, those claims have been corroborated. And people have come out to, like, Dion Cole, Gary Owen, Like, these folks have come out and, like, said, like, yeah, you know, Cat, what he was saying in the interview was pretty true, so. But for me, the main thing was, Cat was just like, not doing this shit anymore. Like, if you're gonna come at me, attack me, or, you know, try to do whatever to me, I am going to let the chopper sing. And, you know, it's funny because I had a friend who posted something similar to her Instagram before the interview. It was just like, not taking no shit. This is the year that I'm letting the chopper spray. So I guess 2024 is just going to be the year of the chopper. I've come to realize that I am too nice. And whereas I don't let people take advantage of me or step on me, I give people too much grace. I give people too many chances. And I'm a little too forgiving. And at my big age, I'm sick of doing that shit. I'm sick of doing it. So I'm really going to let, like, my evil Virgo side take the reins this year. Letting y'all know that I'm just preparing y'all. Alright. On the writing front, still gotta work on some stuff. So y'all know, I am getting back into Azalea. Like, I have been working on it. So for all the people who are, like, talking shit and just like, hey, man up and finish, I'm getting into it. You gotta slow your roll. Don't talk to me like that. You don't know me. But, no, for real. I'm getting into it. And I'm setting a firm goal of finishing Azalea by the end of January. And it's really because I have people that are already just like, yeah, we want to read it. You know, so setting that firm goal. Gonna get into it. Laptop's open. Final draft is launched. Your boy is writing. I am writing. Situations that I had to deal with to kind of make things a little better. I'm hoping that we've gotten to a point to where, all right, I can concentrate and work and write. We'll see. And I also just have hella ideas. Like, I've just been thinking about things, been inspired by things, so I've been taking notes, trying to craft little bare bones outlines for ideas. So, I mean, you know, who knows? Who knows what I'll be able to do and what ideas I will be able to explore this year, but I got them. I got the ideas. So there's that. Also, just really trying to just, like, do better about, like, exercising, you know, getting in shape. One of the things that I vowed to do this year was to get in 10,000 steps every day. And so since January 1st, I've been getting in my 10,000 steps. Like, it does not matter. I walk, you know, try to get them in the daytime. If I can't do it, try to get them in at night. As long as I could hit, you know, 10,000 before midnight on the Apple Watch, I feel like I've done something. I feel a sense of accomplishment. And, you know, like I said, I've been doing it since the first, been hitting that mark every day. And, you know, I've noticed small changes, you know, like, all right, you know, like, I've lost, like, a couple of pounds, and actually, like, sleep seems to be, you know, I seem to be, like, you know, sleeping better. So, I mean, you know, it is what it is. It is what it is. But, yeah, that's definitely, like, you know, a goal of mine this year, 10,000 steps every day, in addition to just working out, eating better, less dumb shit. And finally, I'm gonna start going back to the movies. I've kind of slacked off on going to the movies. The last movie I saw in theaters was The Color Purple, which was good. It was cool. It, you know, it was what it was. But, you know, I got the AMC Stubs thing, so I might as well take advantage of it and, like, see three movies a week, even if I don't want to see, like, a certain movie isn't my jam. If it isn't, you know, it's just like, well, I've got the stubs. I might as, you know, might as well. So I'll be doing that, trying to read more. I've been reading, but I've fallen off from, like, the type of reading that I used to do. So this year, definitely trying to read a lot more, try to, you know, do like a book a week. Also trying to read more fiction. I've really stopped reading fiction over the past few years. And, you know, as a writer, as an author of fiction, That's not good. I don't think that's good. So, I'm gonna try to read more fiction this year, and just share all that with y'all. Let y'all know like what I'm seeing, what I'm reading. If you have any recommendations, please, drop them below. Let me know what I should be getting into. That's about it, friends. That's about it. 2024, as I said, year of the chopper. So, just not taking any more shit, and just trying to do more. Just really trying to do more. We'll see how things go, and I'll catch y'all in the next one.